Hold on, I have to tweet. Today I'm gonna start a piece, a new piece. So first, I like to look for references on Pinterest, which I have open on another window. I just try to save pictures that really make an impact to me. Like when I see it, I go, wow. I want to draw that. That's the type of pictures I save. And then I will start making some thumbnails. First, I'll make some squares or rectangles at the same dimension as same ratio as my canvas. Struggling here for some reason. Okay. That's too thin. Good. Where did I do this? I don't remember. A stroke. There we go. Then a bunch of them on the page. That way I can try out a bunch of options. Because your first idea is never the best one. Sometimes they turn out to be though. Now I can start sketching. Pick the composition, one of the photos, and just follow it. It's a warm up. this first one, the train is going to a far. It's over a bridge. Awesome. And then there's some water down here. Let's try another one. I want to do some vertical options too in a bit. This one, the train is facing the camera, facing us. Like it might be quite challenging to try and do a piece, like a series of me working on a single piece from start to finish, because I'm still not very used to streaming and talking to myself yet. Well, I feel like half of my brain capacity is used on trying to think of what to say. But it's okay. I'm sure I'll get used to it. Okay. And then this is a tunnel. It's a brick wall. Ledge up here. do want to have some characters in the scene. Maybe down here. Cats. Cat villages. I wanted to do a horizontal composition, but a lot of references are vertical format. This one has a lovely, grand-looking bridge. I like these faraway shots, but I'd like to be able to show the details in the steam train, like the different parts. And also some characters, because I feel like that really makes the world come to life to me. When I look at art, I love to look at all the little characters in the background and foreground, because I like to see what they're doing, and that gives me an understanding of the world the artist is trying to create. This one's really nice because it's in water. Well, not in water, but there's a river right here, and you can see the reflection of the train. And the steam too. This one's great because it gives me opportunity to play some characters right here. Some cat. Some cat village townspeople here. Probably catching fish. People hanging out here. This looks like the train piece I drew before. Maybe it's a bit too small. I already did a train piece, but because my computer at the time broke down, I lost the file. Pretty sad. This is probably why I want to draw a train again. Also because I wasn't super happy about the other piece. I feel like I can do better now, hopefully. I want to save this bridge composition for something else I want to draw. It was like a city wall kind of concept. like this one. It's like the welcoming the train and the passengers into the town. This guy can be waving. Try some vertical compositions. Thank you. This one looks really crazy. So cool. The train is heading towards you, and then it's just so much smoke billowing smoke coming out of the chimney and all over the background. Could probably get some pretty cool atmospheric perspective effect with this. And then I can have characters here too. I like this one. Window here. I was making a big pot of stew earlier and I accidentally let in a bunch of flies. Kind of annoying. I hope it's not captured on the audio. I'd be able to hear the pub though. Maybe some kids running in the foreground? It seems dangerous. Don't do that. Okay, reply to message. have to be careful not to close up the space too much, or it's gonna feel claustrophobic. This is so interesting. It's a lot of openings. Interesting shapes. Here is an opening. You can see the background. It's like a bridge. I didn't notice it at first. The trees are diverging here, so it looks really dynamic, and at the same time it frames the scene really nicely. And there's a little stream going on down here. There's a lot of interest in just one picture. Like a tiny waterfall here. Mossy rocks, and then there's a huge log. Ha! There's a huge log going across here. Almost like a dam. This one too. When I'm thumbnailing, I try to not do too much details and just block in the shapes. And I like to... Oh, I do have transfer. Usually I like to make the turn off opacity on my brush, so everything is more black and white and simplified. And I don't get distracted by trying to shade something, because at this stage there's no point in doing that. And detailing me. Some more room down here. Pretty nice foreground room. This tree stops here. This tree stops. Oh, wait. It's here. These tree stumps are here. I'm trying to organize these shapes to show the waterfall clearly. Quite good, complex scene. Thank you. Okay, next. Maybe this one. Like a spiral of smoke. Thank you. six thingies within one section. Clutches. Just do 5 and 1 will be off screen. Pastures in the background. This pollution. To choose some to work to develop. Reflection is nice too. It's not giving the feeling I'm going for. I want it to be like a grand entrance arrival kind of feeling. This one is not really grand arrival, but this is heavy on the adventure feeling, which I really also really like. And I can have a little character here. That would be so fun. Have the villager here. I don't know. And then someone will be looking out the window or standing on the outside, making eye contact, something. This has a lot of potential too. And then I can also have a character right here, which will be framed by the lighting behind this opening. It can be a backlit character too. Backlit character moment. Okay, I think the vertical one is stronger. I'm also more used to this format. Since I'm recording my full process for the first time, maybe I should play to my strengths a little bit more. Should I keep working? I think I'll enlarge these. Maybe I'll keep the frame. Further develop these. find where the stream is coming from. Maybe where I would place the cactus. I think right here. Steam trains have a little balcony at the front sometimes for the operators. Where is it exactly? Along the cylindrical? Oh, it is. Right here. Sometimes they have a little balcony. Someone can stand here. This taller to frame character properly. Someone in the foreground here is minding their own business, fishing or something. I don't know what they should be doing right here. Maybe just walking. I'll figure it out later. Just a little kind of pebbly beach, not beach, but riverside thing going on. I feel like they can be crouching down here doing something. It's fun. Maybe they can be sitting on this log. Dipping their toes in the water. I'm not very pleased. I got bad posture. I like this better. Someone standing up. Maybe casually turning. I could put myself in here. Kids in the background. Maybe just one. Running while holding his hat. He looks like he's flailing. I really like being able to see through this tiny window right here. It gives a lot of depth. This character bigger. think I can wrap it up soon. Can you fish in a stream like this? Or is the water too fast? Cool, and he. Where does the coal compartment go? The steam train? Should be short, and then this one will be long. Long. It all goes right here. Okay. feel like streaming, when you start the stream, it's very hard to figure out, very hard to focus because you're trying to talk when you're not used to it yet. But once I got used to it, it's not so bad. I almost want to keep going, but I have to make dinner. Yeah, I feel like streaming helps me focus. And I like that I'm practicing how to talk, even though I'm on my own right now. But if someone actually starts talking in chat, I might panic. I don't know what'll happen. But right now, I'm pretty happy. Okay. Let's call it a day. Done. Wait, I don't need to draw a smiling face on its side. I can just do this. Oh, doodle. Still don't know how to draw myself quickly yet. Draw yawn. Yawn is a little cat in my pocket. He's always tired. Puggy friend is streaming. Not streaming. She's dreaming. She's making sounds in the background. Okay, gonna make dinner now. Goodbye. I'll pick a thumbnail and keep working on it. Probably tomorrow. And stream. Bye.